inside the Wellness and Events Center, NJIT defeating Hartford by a score of 62-42. Mike Ventola, David Goss, and our entire ESPN crew with you. But for NJIT, able to take care of business this weekend, win both games, a sweep for the first time this season in their first year here of America East Conference play. And with that, we are excited to have head coach Mike Lane with us. And coach, I guess you got to bring out the broom here this afternoon, right? And you get your first sweep. I know, obviously, I'm sure you're on cloud nine right now, but what an effort by your team here in day number two.
Yeah, just really happy. It looked like a second day game there for that first 20 minutes. We couldn't find the net, but I thought we had really good looks all throughout that first quarter. Just nothing could go down. And then just to come out in that second half and just play the way we did and to hold them to 42 points and to get to 60. I felt like we were on two for about 8 minutes. So somehow we scored 60 points, which was great. But just an incredible effort by the girls and really proud of them.
Coach, what can you say about this weekend coming off sweeps on the other direction against UMass Lowell and Maine, which were understandable the last 2 weeks, but emotionally for this team to come back and do what you did this weekend?
Well, I think that was the crucible that we had to go through. You know, UMass Lowell and Maine are the top two teams in the league right now, and I knew they were very good. And it didn't feel very good coming back from Maine, but, you know, I still knew there was a good team here. We hadn't played our best game. We still haven't played our best game. So it was just great to come back, be at home, and play well and execute and really have to win two different games. These were different games from, you know, yesterday to today. So I thought that showed incredible maturity by our group. And, you know, we're just really happy to end our winter break here with two wins, and now we can go into the semester.
And what about the double-double, the leading rebounder on your team standing to your right in the point guard, Lyzi Litwinko?
Yeah, that's why we brought her here, for rebounding. she's all over the floor. She had 9 rebounds yesterday. She's not giving up on that possession. And we need to rebound out of the guard spot. That's been something that has been important to us. You know, Kenna rebounds out of that guard spot a lot. But Lyzi was great here at the line today as well. Just a really nice job. I know I'm in her ear maybe just about every other possession on some other decisions, but it's still only like your 12th or 13th game. So there's still a lot to learn, but she's certainly the heartbeat of this club. When she plays well and plays tough, the kids feed off of that.
Coach, it's amazing. You get the opportunity as well too to really jump up in the standings. You know, you're in fourth place today. I mean, you're in a tie for that fourth place. So I know still early in a sense of, you know, thinking too much far ahead, but knowing now that in a way your team is in a driver's seat here moving forward, how much does it excite you to get back to work and get prepared for your next matchup at Stony Brook?
Yeah, we're not quite there where we're looking at the standings, Mike. We're still going one game at a time. That's how we have to play. That's how we took this weekend. We're still a young group, so we can't start to look ahead. We can't start to look at standings. We can't start to look at statistics. We're just playing. You know, play our game, play our possession, play the way we want to play, and all that stuff will take care of itself.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for joining us as always. Enjoy this one, and best of luck on the road against Stony Brook next weekend.
We will, Mike. I just want to note, I told the girls before the game that NJIT hadn't won back-to-back games since 2013 when they won the Great West. So Lyzi was 8 years old, or 10. You were 10.
Oh, that's great. Well, Lyzi, Mike and David here with you. And Lyzi, you know, what a day for you as well. I know David, he had talked about the numbers, obviously, with the double-double. But for you, knowing that your team has had to work so hard, especially now, to win both of these games, how much you feel like that all that hard work and preparation was finally rewarded here after these 2 days?
Oh, it's definitely a great feeling. Like Coach Lane said, we hadn't had back-to-back wins in a long, long time. And I really think we needed that, especially coming off of Maine. Like, I really feel like this is giving us the energy we need to keep going and keep winning and play the basketball we know we can.
For you, obviously a freshman, but you came out flying out of the gates, playing even better now. How do you feel like you're seeing the game reacting to the Division I America East level?
I feel like I'm seeing it better. I'm starting to get more comfortable. My teammates obviously make that easy. Like coming down in transition, they're putting themselves in the right spots and they make it easy to find them. So,
you know, Lyzi, so much effort not only for what you and your team are doing in practice each day, but this camaraderie. You can see the enthusiasm. Everyone is supporting one another. How much has that kind of made it easier too as the season's gone along now? You're starting to battle more. You're starting to really get into the thick of things here in the schedule. How much has this camaraderie really helped you guys keep your focus day in and day out?
a lot. Like, these girls are awesome. They're my sisters at the end of the day. We spend a lot of time together, so we definitely have great team chemistry, and I love being around them, and I think that shows on the floor. Like, always high-fiving each other, always stepping up for each other, always keeping the energy high. I think it's an awesome environment to play in, and I'm very, very grateful to be with all these girls.
Well, Lyzi, we're excited to continue to watch you grow and play, and best of luck here on the road at Stony Brook, and we look forward to talking with you again soon.
Thank you so much.